On behalf of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts Municipal Police Training Committee, I would like to welcome distinguished guests, law enforcement officials, and family and friends who are here today to celebrate the graduation exercises of the 5th Recruit Officer Class. My name is Laura Thomas. I'm the Academy Director for the Randolph Police Academy and today's MC. The class has been led in by the Irish American Police Officers Association Pipe and Drums and will be led in by the Brockton Police Honor Guard. Please stand to welcome the graduates of the 5th Recruit Officer Course.
Get through! stop. Alert!
Reverend David Lima, pastor of New Seasons Worship Center and executive minister of Interchurch Council of Greater Bedford. Reverend Lima.
I am proud to be the chaplain for the New Bedford Police Department. You bow your heads. God of all knowledge, we stand before you celebrating this class of recruits who have acquired the skills and education necessary to go into the world protecting the public from criminals and evildoers. All human education is limited, and there is so much more they can still learn, more skills that they could have and acquire. Help them to remember that education is not a one-time activity, but a lifelong process. May they be open to continuing their educations through advice and training from other experienced officers. As these recruits take their oaths to become sworn officers, help them to always remember what they are promising. Integrity is of utmost importance in law enforcement. Opportunities to do less than right, look the other way, and abuse the office they hold will always be in front of them. Give these recruits the courage to hold fast to the oaths they're about to take. Strengthen them during times of temptation. Let their service be a credit to their families, to the department they serve, and to their communities. May they live their lives with the greatest integrity. May this recruit class be commendable examples of what law enforcement is all about. As these recruits go into the field to be with their families and friends, help their families to be supportive and understanding. Without support, nobody can function at their best. May these recruits always have places they can go to recharge their batteries and find renewal. Also, we are thankful for the staff of the Randolph Academy and for their efforts to train these cadets to be the best they can be. Continue to bless the efforts of the trainers and instructors. Lastly, we pray for the community these recruits are about to go and serve as sworn law enforcement officers. Help the community to appreciate their efforts to protect them. May the community insist they have appropriate equipment and adequate pay. Most of all, inspire the community to pray for law enforcement daily and to obey the law themselves. And for those who have chosen the bad path, trip them up so they will get caught. Turn their illegal profits into dust. Terrify them at night to encourage repentance. On this day of celebration, these are our prayers. Hear them and answer them, O Lord. Amen.
Platoon, attend, hut! Half, right, face! Ready, seats!
Please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, I am privileged to introduce the 47 student officers of the 5th recruit officer class, whose accomplishments we are here to celebrate today. It is also my honor to introduce those participating in our ceremony today. To my right, Mary Lou Powers, Director of Training of the MPTC, Dan Zivkovich, Executive Director of the MPTC. To lead our law enforcement oath of honor, Chief Robert Zala of the Dartmouth Police Department. Delivering the invocation and benediction, Reverend David Lima, Chaplain of the New Bedford Police Department. Our singer, Cassidy McGrath. And on my left are our staff instructors who've worked each day with the class. Each of them works full-time as a police supervisor for their own police department and works part-time for the police academy, overseeing the day-to-day discipline of the ROC and serving as mentors and role models for the student officers. Senior staff instructor, Sergeant Richard Tapper from the Quincy Police Department, Lieutenant Robert Casey from the Boston University Police Department, Lieutenant Matt Tobin from the Quincy Police Department, Special Agent Benjamin Levine from the CSX Police Department, Sergeant Kevin Malloy from the Weymouth Police Department. Also on stage is our lead PT instructor, Officer Sean Reedy from the Pembroke Police Department, and representatives from each of the 22 police departments with recruits enrolled in this fifth ROC. At this time, I would like to invite MPTC Executive Director Dan Zivkovic to the podium to say a few words. Executive Director.
And the few words comment was not lost on me, Director. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of Governor Baker and Secretary Bennett of the Executive Office of Public Safety and Security and the Municipal Police Training Committee, welcome. And thank you, as the Director says, for being here today to help us celebrate the successes and accomplishments of this class. And to you, class, I offer our collective congratulations for achieving this milestone in your career. And also, Director, and your staff, I offer our collective appreciation for all the time, thought, effort, and sacrifices all of you have made to bring these men and women to this point in their career. It's not lost on all of us that every time the recruits had to be here at 6, somebody had to be here at 5:30. Every time they left at midnight, somebody was there until the next morning. And recognize that all of these staff instructors have full-time jobs and have chosen voluntarily to help further our profession by participating in this class. Thank you, all of you, for what you've done. Class, I'd be remiss if I didn't offer you a few words based on my 35 years in the profession as a trooper, as a police chief, as an academy director, and now as the executive director of the Municipal Police Training Committee. I have a few challenges for you, but let me start by saying what an exciting time to be coming into policing. Now, I'd be surprised if a family member or a friend hasn't questioned your career choice based on the conversations going on across the country and the scrutiny being placed on police officers. But you know what? That's exactly why this is an exciting time to get into policing. Now, certainly in your academy training, you've talked about the role of police in the 21st century and in a modern society and how our profession has evolved. And you've also had conversations about warriors versus guardians and recognize that it's not either or, it's both, with the emphasis on guardians. But with that in mind, I have four challenges for you as you leave here today. My first is the cornerstone of our profession, is to remember that by statute, by profession, you are police officers, not law enforcement. Now, while many people use those terms interchangeably, there's a subtle and yet very distinct difference between the two. Because if you go to work every day thinking that your job is law enforcement, then you will think your job is to write tickets, make arrests. But in reality, that's but a very small part of your job. In reality, if you go to work every day realizing that your profession is about policing, you will realize that your mission, your goal, your job is to protect and serve. And that tickets and arrests are but two of the options available to you out of the hundreds in any given situation. So always remember, you're police officers, not just law enforcement. My second challenge to you is to serve with honor. And in our profession, honor means keeping your promises, the promises you make to your community and to the profession in your oath of honor, in your values, and in our code of ethics. Honor means doing what's right because it's the right thing to do, not simply because somebody will find out or simply because it's required. So I challenge you to always serve with honor. My third challenge to you is to echo what Pastor Lima said. Serve with courage. Now, certainly we expect you to have physical courage, bravery in the face of danger. But in our profession, there's another dimension to courage. There's ethical courage. It takes courage to do what's right. It takes courage to serve ethically and with integrity. So my third challenge to you is always have the courage to do what's right, to serve ethically, and to serve with integrity, despite obstacles, despite temptations, and yes, sometimes despite peer pressure. And my fourth challenge to you is to serve with commitment, a commitment to your community, a commitment to the profession, and just as importantly, a commitment to yourselves. And the cornerstone of that commitment has to be striving for excellence in everything you do. In other words, never settle for simply being better than the person next to you. Never settle for simply being good enough to get a good performance review or good enough to get promoted. Never settle for the minimum, because there is no room for mediocrity in police work. You have to strive to be the best that you can be at all times. Now, you've been tested, retested, and tested yet again. But you have yet to take the final exam. And no, Sergeant Tapper and Director Thomas are not going to take you out into one of these classrooms and give you another test. The reality is, the final exam is going to take every bit of courage, honor, commitment, common sense, and energy you have to offer. Because the final exam actually starts when you get to these doors at the end of the ceremony. Because at that point, 70%, 80%, 90%, and yes, sometimes 100% is no longer good enough. Nobody wants a police officer showing up on their doorstep that's only 90% good at police work. Moreover, now that you're police officers, you've lost the right to be unfit. And in our profession, fitness has three dimensions. The first is certainly physical fitness. Your peers, your community, expect you to be physically prepared to perform the demands of the job on a moment's notice. And certainly there's moral fitness, always acting ethically and with integrity. But the third dimension that's often overlooked is mental fitness. As Reverend Lima just said, your learning does not stop here. It pretty much starts here. This is what you need to do to be successful in the profession. You have to watch, you have to ask, you have to listen. You have to take every opportunity to improve your knowledge and skills to constantly strive to be the best that you can be. So this is not the end of your learning, it's the beginning of your learning. And most of all, if you run into something you don't know, find the answer. Because there's no way you can be the best that you can be if there's things you know you don't know. So my challenges to you are quite simple. Always remember that you're police officers, not simply law enforcement. And I challenge you to serve with honor, with courage, and a commitment to excellence in everything you do, every hour of every shift, of every day. Congratulations and Godspeed.
Thank you very much, Executive Director. It gives me great pleasure to now introduce our keynote speaker selected by the class. Detective Sergeant Richard Tapper has been with the Quincy Police Department for 29 years. For the past several years, he has been the supervisor of the Drug Control Unit. Detective Sergeant Tapper has held many elite positions throughout his career in Quincy, including being the Special Operations Unit, Motorcycle Officer, Accident Reconstructionist, Dive Team, Firearms Instructor, Defensive Tactics Instructor, and Supervisor of the Bureau of Criminal Investigations, just to name a few positions. He's been an instructor for MPTC since 2002. Detective Sergeant Tapper has been awarded many honors and citations over his career, most notably receiving one of the highest awards in law enforcement, the Hanna Award for Valor. He also holds a master's degree in criminal justice. In 2005, Detective Sergeant Tapper became an MPTC staff instructor for the Weymouth and then the Randolph Police Academies, and as of today, he will have graduated 8 recruit officer classes and has been the senior staff instructor for the last 3. It says here in my introduction that today is his last class, but that can't be right, but it is. I'm saddened. Today's graduating class will be senior staff instructor, Sergeant Tapper's final recruit officer class. It is my great pleasure to introduce Sergeant Richard Tapper.
Director Dan Jankovic, Director of Training Mary Lou Powers, Academy Director Lara Thomas, academy staff, police chiefs, family, friends, and the fifth recruit officer classes. It is an honor and privilege to speak before you, but this is my last and final recruit class. I'd like to congratulate each one of you for reaching the light at the end of the tunnel. Over the last 6 months, each one of you have shown dedication, self-discipline, and motivation each day you arrived at the academy. Let us not forget the sacrifices that your families have endured over that time. At this moment, I would like you to stand and face the ones that stood by you and give them a well-deserved round of applause. So class, Phoebe! Oh, Phoebe! On August 2nd, at 06:30 hours, you walked through the front doors of the academy with a look of uncertainty. You took your seats and you were greeted by Director Thomas. After the director left, you sat all alone in a quiet classroom. I can't imagine the thoughts that were going through your heads. Well, that all changed as the clock struck 0700 hours. You were all greeted by several highly motivated drill instructors that turned your day upside down with chaos. It was like watching the first day of kindergarten, where you had to be taught to count off, learn your left from your right, and to use a bathroom single file. A big part of your training was attention to detail, time management, and multitasking. Who would ever thought that you could run 42 male recruits to a head call in 10 minutes? From Black Monday to the last day of the academy, everything that you do, that you were exposed to had a purpose as becoming a police officer. We had the task of taking 47 pieces of unmolded clay and constructively shaping and molding each one of you. After 6 months, the final product is what you see here before us today, police officers. You are now police officers. How others view you and forever change. Everything you say and do will be scrutinized in a different way. How you present yourself will not only be a reflection of you, but of your agency and all police officers. Your command presence, ability to remain calm, and handle highly stressful situations, sometimes unimaginable, professional, is a crucial to your success. Follow the golden rule, to always treat those you call to assist as you would wish to be treated. Treat the citizens of your cause as you would want your family to be treated, and offer them the same protections you would to your flesh and blood. Always remember to do what is right, and never forget that evil is perpetrated when we look the other way and do nothing. Even though your academy training has come to an end, continue to train and learn throughout your career. In my 29 years of policing, one of the most important lessons that I learned is the importance of training and continued learning. Policing is constantly evolving, whether it's mass general laws, defensive tactics, or patrol procedures, to name a few. Remember, as you train, so shall you perform. In conclusion, I would like to thank Director Lara Thomas for doing an outstanding job of not only this recruit class, but of the previous classes I've had the pleasure to work with her. Director Thomas's organizational skills, preparedness, and dedication to the academy have made mine and all the staff instructors' jobs much easier. She is an outstanding police academy director, and I thank her again. Thank you to staff instructors for another job well done, and encourage you to continue to mold the clay into highly motivated, highly dedicated police officers. Also, I'd like to wish a speedy and safe return to Officer Dylan Hicks from the Rochester Police Department, who will be deploying overseas with his military unit in the months ahead. And to the 5th Recruit Officers class, thank you all for being one of the top classes that I have had the privilege to mentor. I am only a phone call away, or in these days, a text. Even though we wear different patches, we are all one team. Until our paths cross again, I wish you all the best and want you to have a long and safe career. Thank you.
Wait one moment, please. Sorry, Captain. I have spent a lot of time trying to think of the right words to recognize your outstanding career of service to police training, but I'm happy that the 5th ROC helped me out. Quoting from their very recently submitted final evaluations, here's some key quotes. He yelled at us when we needed it. He mentored us when we needed it. He was always open when he had a question. He has an uncanny ability in his command presence to get the best out of you. He is an inspiration to me as a future police officer as I admire his passion and dedication to his career. Great job, great man, great leader. And my favorite, Sergeant Tapper made me want to be the best police officer I could be. He inspired me to try to go above and beyond just being average. And those are just a few comments from the class. To say you'll be missed is a gross understatement. It is with great personal affection and in honor of your dedicated service to hundreds of future police officers over 8 academy classes that we'd like to present you with this plaque and our sincere gratitude. Cesarini, and new instructors, Officers Ryan Quirk, Derek Scully, and Brendan Canary. Although MPT doesn't use them as our standard, the Cooper standards for law enforcement, which adjust for gender and age, provide a solid means for looking at recruits' PT performance and gauging their progress. At our initial fitness assessment on August 3rd, 60% of the class fell into Cooper's fair, poor, or very poor categories overall. But, it gets better. At our final assessment on January 10th, no one was in the poor or very poor categories. 17% were rated fair, 40% were rated good, and 45% of the class was in the excellent or superior categories of fitness. Yes. This is the ratings for somehow and above with the Cooper standards. That's really tremendous progress. Nearly every recruit shaved significant amounts of time off their run pace and showed remarkable improvement in our sit-ups and push-up assessments. And I don't have a solid measurement for this, but I would estimate the 5th ROC left many gallons of sweat and other spewed liquids on the field of track right outside the doors at Massasoit. These accomplishments are due in no small part to our lead PT instructor, Officer Sean Reedy, who will present the PT award. Officer Reedy.
Good morning. Again, I want to echo what the director said. I want to thank all the PT staff, because without you, your hard work and dedication, we definitely wouldn't work. This was definitely a strong PT class with a great attitude, so it's working out. But when looking at Cooper percentiles, it was a class standout. Finishing the 95th percentile with the final 1.5 mile run under 10 minutes, the Randolph 5th ROC Physical Fitness Award goes to Recruit Officer Robert Atwood from the Brockton Police Department.
Thank you, Officer Lee. Staff instructors will present our remaining awards. to present the Academic Excellence Award to Lieutenant Matthew Tobin from the Quincy Police Department.
Good morning. The 5th ROC took 14 written tests, multiple practical exams, firearms qualifications, EBOC, all during their 25 weeks with the academy. The winner of the Academic Excellence Award finished with a 97.65 grade point average, just 1/10 higher than the second ranked recruit. It should be noted that he maintained his high academic achievement while taking on the additional responsibility and serving admirably as one of the strongest platoon leaders the Randolph Police Academy has had the pleasure of working with. The Academic Award of Excellence for the 5th ROC is awarded to Recruit Officer Dylan Hicks from the Rochester Police Department.
Or EBOC, and firearms. In order to pick a top gun, we need to have a competition that is something that can be done within each group, and the final results compared. That means that it needs to be a combination of accuracy and time. The recruit with the best overall score in firearms is Officer Eric DeSell of the Plymouth Police Department.
The staff award for the 5th Randolph ROC is awarded to Gregory Servo of the Sharon Police Department.
Congratulations to all awardees. I would now like to invite Class President James LaRusso of the Norfolk Police Department forward to address the class.
Not have been easy listening to complain about mostly everything, but you did
did in 10th grade. Finally, we would like to thank the whole academy staff. As we were told at orientation, you were going to take us and mold us into the best law enforcement officers you could, and also how to do burpees, First Sergeant. You have prepared yet another fine group of young officers for the challenges of law enforcement, and we thank you.
Platoon, seat!
So I wasn't aware all the chiefs were going to sit behind me, so I'm probably going to have to cut this pretty short. I know everyone is anxious to complete the ceremony and get out of here, so I'll be brief. I hear we're getting out early on the camera, so don't worry about it. 6 months, it wasn't so bad. Went by pretty quick for everyone in the room but the recruits. It seems like just yesterday, Graham was running around the squad bay wearing his Crocs with white socks, telling everyone how much he loved them. While Tyler was in the hallway with his high-vid vest, directing traffic, right up to the end of the county with McGrath singing Taylor Swift. We survived the physical and mental training of the academy. We played the game. We won the game. And we are here today to celebrate our victory. And we'll be the Patriots do also this Sunday. The biggest thing we have learned as recruits in this academy, from every staff instructor, PT instructor, and subject matter instructor, is that our family is first. They were here before we attended the academy. They were here as we trained through the academy. And they will be there the day we hang up our duty belts. Our number one job to our families is to be home safe. We just got the front row seat to the best job in the world, fellas. Be safe, look out for each other, and always do the right thing when no one is looking. Thank you. I would like to have the Vice President, Recruit Officer McGrath, please join me on stage. A little token of gratitude for Director Thomas, keeping in touch with all of us, email, answering our questions, dealing with everything we got away.
We will proudly display your class plaque in our hallway at the academy. I know some of you had the idea that we could hang your individual pictures in the hallway and maybe take up the whole hallway, but I think the plaque will be great. Thank you. This class is now ready to assume their duties as police officers. The diplomas about to be handed to graduates are hard-earned and represent 6 months of dedication to a highly disciplined and structured training program. Our Executive Director, Dan Sifkovich, and Director of Training, Mary Lou Powers, will assist in awarding the certificates, and each squad will assemble at the front of the auditorium to be pinned. Please wait until the entire squad has received their diplomas, and then we will invite you up for the badge pinning by squad. The pinners will come forward once the entire squad is in position.
Thank you.
As they have been for the past 25 weeks, the class is preceded by our guidon bearer, Adam Plant, of the Attleboro Police Department, who will be pinned by his mother, Lori, and father, Gary, an auxiliary lieutenant for the Attleboro Police Department. Our platoon leader, Dylan Hicks, Rochester Police Department, pinned by his wife, Destiny Hicks, and his father, David Hicks. Squad 1 leader, Erin McIsaac, Sharon Police Department, being pinned by her mother, Kathy Isaac, and children, Sean and Casey. Ryan Hemphill of Krishna Police Department, who will be pinned by his wife, Kristen Hemphill, and daughters, Zoe and Emmy. James LaRusso, Norfolk Police Department, being pinned by his wife, Lindsay LaRusso, and children, Hunter and Lacey. Brandon Sherritt, Attleboro Police Department, pinned by his parents, Kathy Stoddard, and Scott Sherritt, and his girlfriend, Danielle Salisbury. Caleb LaRue, Wareham Police Department, pinned by his girlfriend, Scotland Adler. Garrett Smith, Attleboro Police Department, pinned by his fiancée, Kelly Lewis Hicks. Michael Chin, Canton Police Department, pinned by his aunt, Officer Joanne O'Brien of the Chelsea Police Department, his mother, Paula Chin, and his grandfather, John O'Brien. Andrew Bennett, Waltham Police Department, pinned by his mother, Jane Bennett, his grandmother, Margaret Gustafson, and his girlfriend, Emily Desprez. Corey Ketterer, Plymouth Police Department, pinned by his parents, Maureen and Chris Ketterer, and his girlfriend, Jillian White. Seth Levine, Taunton Police Department, pinned by his father, Captain Stephen Levine of the Taunton Fire Department, his mother, Kimberly Levine, and his brother, Officer Evan Levine of the Taunton Police Department. Isabella Miranda, Plymouth Police Department, pinned by her father, Jose Miranda, and her mother, Katya Miranda. Caroline Devon, Brockton Police Department, pinned by her parents, Bill and Mary Devon.
Thanks.
Pinners for Squad 1, please come forward and pin your graduates. Congratulations, Squad 1.
Squad 1, ride, pace, forward, march. Squad 1, left, face. Seats. Squad 2, right, face. Forward, march.
Squad 2 leader Greg Servo, Sharon Police Department, who will be pinned by Detective Mike Newt of the New York City Police Department. Cusson, Dartmouth Police Department, pinned by his parents Tim and Jennifer Cusson and his girlfriend Michaela Dreher. Christopher Sorge, Mansfield Police Department, pinned by his parents Dave and Pat Sorge. Pinned by his parents, Michael and Susan Tyler. Craig Pimentel, Acushnet Police Department, pinned by his father, Kenneth Pimentel, retired New Bedford police officer. Robert Atwood, Brockton Police Department, pinned by his wife, Dominique Atwood, and children, Connor and Landon. Scott Kane, Duxbury Police Department, pinned by Reverend Irene Harding and Sergeant Tom Brown and Officer Steve Hall of Duxbury PD. Donald Hagar, Athol PD, pinned by his father, retired Sergeant Ken Hagar of Athol PD. Alec Grant, Dartmouth PD, pinned by his parents, Donna and Stephen Grant, and his girlfriend, Kelsey Breakup. Shannon O'Donnell, Brockton Police Department, being pinned by her father, Corrections Officer Michael O'Donnell. Sarah Martin, Waltham Police Department, being pinned by her sister, Mary Ann Martin, and her mother, Mary Martin. Pinners for Squad 2, please come forward and pin the graduates. Congratulations, Squad 2. Peter Barsan, Waltham PD, pinned by his parents Rick and Lori Barsan. Mark Duhamel, Brockton PD, pinned by his wife Rachel Duhamel and father Douglas Duhamel. Edward Newcomb, Brockton Police Department, pinned by his wife Ruth Newcomb and his children Jay and Alyssa Newcomb. Alexander Bush, Falmouth PD, being pinned by his father Arthur Bush and his fiance Danielle Ranger. Michael Kane, Plymouth Police Department, being pinned by his wife Samantha Kane. Brian McGrath, Sharon Police Department, being pinned by his father, Officer Stephen McGrath of the Foxborough Police Department. James Butler, Attleboro Police Department, pinned by his wife, Mary Butler. Jeremy Del C, New Bedford Police Department, being pinned by his mother, Robin Carlin. Matthew Correa, Dartmouth Police Department, been pinned by his parents, Tony and Liz Correa, and his fiance, Jessica Romeo. William White, Medway Police Department, being pinned by his wife, Holly White.
Thank you.
Squad 3 please come forward and pin the graduates? Congratulations, Squad 3. By his parents David and Susan Craven and his girlfriend Stacy Crowan. Cody Murray, Falmouth Police Department, pinned by his father Bob Murray, retired from Falmouth PD, his mother Ingrid Murray and his girlfriend Alexis Marcus. Matthew Farrell, Brockton Police Department, pinned by his girlfriend Tabitha Doniger and daughter McKenna Farrell. William McKenzie, Attleboro Police Department, pinned by his wife Sandra McKenzie and son Carter McKenzie. Earl Bostick, Attleboro Police Department, pinned by his daughters Delaney and Nyani Bostick. Andrew Horan, Brockton Police Department, pinned by his uncles Edward Horan and Corrections Officer William Horan. Stephen Pereira, Dighton Police Department, pinned by his wife Jennifer Pereira and his children Brody, Paisley, Kylie, and Allie. Department, pinned by his parents Jean and Patty O'Brien and his girlfriend Colleen Hogan. Michael Curley, Plymouth Police Department, pinned by his father John Curley, retired from the Boston Police Department. And last but not least, Samuel Alvarez Mojica, New Bedford Police Department, pinned by his wife Ashley Santiago Arocho and his son Samuel Allen. Henry Spahn IV, please come forward. Congratulations, Squad 4. Chief Robert Zala of the Dartmouth Police Department to come forward to administer the law enforcement oath of honor. All current and former law enforcement officials are invited to please stand to join him. Chief Zala.
Platoon! Feet!
Turn the Academy guide on to the staff at graduation. I would like to now ask our first and fastest, Officer Adam Plant of the Alamo Police Department, to please come forward and return the guidon to the Academy staff represented by Lieutenant Robert Casey. Sincere appreciation to all those who participated in the ceremony today, and to Massasoit Campus Police, Linda Barolini, Mark Rocheteau, Teresa Gonzalez, and the entire team here at Massasoit Community College who really bent over backwards to make sure the ceremony was a success. To my staff instructors, you continue to be the heart and lifeblood of this academy and to exceed my expectations in the way we serve as role models and mentors to our recruits. Thank you for your amazing efforts and all the sacrifices you have made to invest your time into creating outstanding future police officers. And a few final words to the 5th ROC. A Longfellow poem about success caught my eye and made me think of your last 6 months. From the Ladder of St. Augustine, "We have not wings, we cannot soar, but we have feet to scale and climb, by slow degrees, by more and more, the cloudy summits of our time. The mighty pyramids of stone that wedge-like cleave the desert airs, when near seen and better known, are but gigantic flights of stairs. The distant mountains that uprear their solid bastions to the skies are crossed by pathways that appear as we to higher levels rise. The heights by great men reached and kept were not attained by sudden flight, but they, while their companions slept, were toiling upward in the night." Does this sound vaguely familiar, 5th ROC? Distant mountains, slow degrees, other people sleeping while you are training. Nelson Mandela put it more simply, it always seems impossible until it's done. 25 weeks, 125 training days. On August 1st, when you ran around the parking lot and scrambled to account for all your equipment, struggled to count off properly, sweated through your new khaki uniforms, this day seemed like it would never come. You've gone through burst desks, the heat of August, the chill of January, structured breaks and unstructured breaks, armbar takedowns and barricaded suspects, hundreds, maybe thousands, PowerPoint slides. And through it all, you conducted yourself admirably. You have made me very proud from your first day to your last scenarios at ABP at the Brockton Fairgrounds. Thank you for the honor of serving as your director. And another of my favorite philosophers, Mr. Rogers, said something I said to my own children when tragic events occurred. He said, "When I was a boy and I would see scary things in the news, my mother would say to me, look for the helpers. You always find people who are helping." Having the 47 of you representing those helpers that people will look to makes me feel very proud and very hopeful. You have proven yourselves worthy of the mission to protect and serve, and I wish you long, safe, and successful careers. I would now like to ask Reverend Lima to deliver the benediction, followed by Ms. McGrath singing God Bless America.
Two, three,
I offer my congratulations to the class. God bless you all. Bow your heads. Almighty God, we pray for all these who as police officers have accepted the task of keeping peace and order in your world. Make them aware of the great responsibility that is theirs in this sacred calling. Strengthen them in trying times. Give them patience, wisdom, and compassion. Guide and guard them in their duty, and grant that they may find understanding and friendship among your people. Let them forever remember that their oaths were taken before their fellow officers, their families, their communities, and you, Lord. May they fulfill the greatest traditions of all the law officers who have gone before them. May all of us keep them in our hearts and prayers. Bless them and their loved ones, Lord, and ever keep them in your loving care. And may you always come home safe. We thank you, O God, for hearing our prayers here today. Amen.
Sergeant Tapper, for the last time, please dismiss the officers of the 5th Recruit Officer Course. Oh, I'm sorry. Yes, actually. Cassidy McGrath will sing first.
God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above. From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans, wide with
please dismiss the officers of the 5th Recruit Officer Course.
Tune, hop, right, face! Randolph, 5th ROC, dismissed!
War team!
Thank you for coming.